Hello everyone, welcome to chemistry class. Here we are with the next part of the chapter number 9. The topic we'll be discussing is now some useful properties of carbon. So we have already seen various forms of the carbon and their different uses. We'll see an important property, that is adsorption, which is a physical property that is observed in one of the forms of the carbon. So before we move on to that particular topic, let us understand what this process is. So adsorption is a physical process. In this, what is happening is that a thin layer of a substance is formed on another surface of a particular substance. That means a separate layer will deposit of a given substance on another substance. So the substance which is forming this layer, it is called as adsorbate, and the substance on which it is made, it is called as adsorbent. Here it is given, the substance on the surface of which adsorption takes place is called as adsorbent. For example, oil forms a layer on water. If you put oil and water together, oil will collect upside. So on the surface of water, oil has deposited. This is the process of adsorption. Don't confuse it with absorption. It is adsorption. The substance which is above, that is called as adsorbate. So in this particular example of oil and water, this particular oil will be called as adsorbate, and the surface on which oil has deposited, that is water. So water will be called as adsorbent. These two terms you have to remember, adsorbate and adsorbent. This completes the process of adsorption. That is, a separate layer will form of a given substance on another surface. So this is how adsorption takes place. It is a surface phenomena only, and a thin layer of the adsorbed substance is formed at the surface of the adsorbent. So another example we'll see. Example is given. For example, moisture is adsorbed at any solid surface when the substance is exposed to moist air. You take any substance in open air, it will absorb moisture. In the moist air, it will absorb moisture, and water layer will deposit there, that is moisture will deposit there. So moisture is getting adsorbed there. Moisture is doing the adsorption process. Same next example, already I have told you, the formation of a thin film of oil over the surface of water is another example of adsorption. So this is how adsorption takes place, and it is dependent totally upon the surface area. If larger is the surface area, then greater is the adsorption, and vice versa. Smaller the surface area, smaller the adsorption. So more surface area is available in one of the forms of the carbon, that is amorphous form. Carbon exists in two forms, crystalline and amorphous structure, true solid or pseudo solids. But in the true solids, surface area is less. In the amorphous solids, or that is like a charcoal and all, their surface area is more. So here we will now learn the topic, that is adsorption by charcoals. It is what type of carbon? It is amorphous form of the carbon only. So because it is amorphous form, that is why it will have large surface area. As a result, it exhibits the property of a good adsorbent. Charcoal is a good adsorbent because it is amorphous form of the carbon, and because of the property of adsorption being exhibited by the charcoals, there are different uses of charcoal that we will learn now. What we are going to learn is the different uses of the different type of the charcoal. First is the wood charcoal. It is a good adsorbent of the gases, and because it does the adsorption of the gases, it can be used in making the gas mask to purify the air, to remove the poisonous gas. Especially the people who are working in the polluted areas, they can wear these gas masks and they can remain safe from the poisonous gases. An active form of this same charcoal is prepared from the coconut shells. It can also be made from the it can be also be employed in the process of making the gas mask. Next is bone charcoal, that is made by the animal bones. It is used to remove the brown impurities from the unrefined sugar. So when the refining of the sugar is being done, the impurities are removed, especially the brown impurities are removed using the brown charcoal. Brown charcoal will do the adsorption and it will separate out the impurities from the unrefined sugar. Next, many impurities of water are removed by the filtration process through charcoal only. This charcoal is present in the UV purifier, that is the RO. mineral water where you get, in that only charcoal layer is there. It can be helpful in purifying the water. Not all the UV purifiers are having this facility. Few nowadays, few of them are having. Next, the municipal water treatment plant also may be purged through charcoal to remove the impurities of the water. Next is activated coconut charcoal. It is used to separate a mixture of noble gases. Different mixture of noble gases, if they are present together in the same container, they can be separated by heating them. If we heat the mixture of noble gas and pass through the activated coconut charcoal, that at different temperature, a different noble gas will get adsorption of different gases will take place at different temperatures, and we can thus separate the different gases present in the mixture of noble gases. What are the noble gases? Few examples of these gases are given: helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon. All these are the noble gases, and they can be separated from the same mixture by adsorption using the activated coconut charcoal. Next is, activated charcoal also facilitates various chemical reactions, and hence it is used as a catalyst. Catalyst is any substance which helps in the chemical reaction. It increases the rate of the reaction. The speed by which reaction is proceeding will become faster. Example, we'll see hydrogen and chlorine both react with each other normally, but it is a very slow process. It needs some amount of light also. But if you have to do this reaction in darkness, normally hydrogen chlorine will not react. But if you put activated charcoal there in the dark in a dark room, you take hydrogen and chlorine, and if you try to react them, they will not react. But if you put activated charcoal in the same reaction only, if there is a presence of this activated charcoal in hydrogen and chlorine, then they will react and they will start producing the desired product. Hydrogen chloride gas will form. So the reaction between hydrogen and chlorine in darkness is otherwise very, very slow. If the charcoal is present there, then the reaction can take place. Reaction can easily happen there. So that is all 5 points we have seen. We have completed here all the topic about the adsorption. Now let us see the chemical properties of carbon. Physical property we have seen of carbon. Now we'll move to the chemical properties of carbon. First one is the reaction with air. Carbon, when it is reacting with air, means it is burning. Whenever any reaction with air is written, it is related to combustion process. And combustion means what? Combustion means anything is burning. So here now we'll see the burning of carbon. Carbon burns in the presence, in excess of air, extra air or oxygen, to form what? To form carbon dioxide. So this is the equation: C plus O2 gives CO2 plus heat. Amount of heat, large amount of heat is released, and the carbon, all of that is converted into carbon dioxide. This is addition of oxygen. If proper oxygen is not available, if there is insufficient supply of the oxygen, then CO2, carbon dioxide, will not produce. Carbon monoxide will produce. So this is another equation. Both the equation you can see there. Heat is getting produced. If proper oxygen is there, then CO2. If less oxygen is there, then CO will be produced. Also, this carbon monoxide, if you heat that, if this particular gas, then what will happen? On heating means what? That is, burning will take place, and this carbon monoxide will combine with the oxygen of the air to convert into carbon dioxide. So that is all you can observe here. Everywhere in each of these reactions of the burning of carbon, heat is being produced. So what we will read here, that is, the heat produced in these reaction makes carbon a good fuel. That is why carbon is a very good fuel, and like coal, petrol and all they contain carbon, and that is because these fuels are able to produce more energy because carbon is a good fuel. Point number 2, that is reducing properties. Reducing means to remove oxygen. Another one is there, to add hydrogen. If you remove oxygen or if you add hydrogen in a given compound or chemical, then it is called as reduction. Carbon is having the same benefit in this case also of the reducing properties. So carbon has some affinity for oxygen. What is the meaning of affinity? Is attraction. It is a little bit attracted towards oxygen. So what it will do? So it combines with the oxygen in the presence of many compounds and act as a reducing agent. Carbon will combine with oxygen, and we will get another gas, that is carbon monoxide, and then it will act as a reducing agent. Reaction of reduction we will see now of the metal oxides. let us understand this particular reaction. Same thing only that we have just now read, carbon will combine with oxygen and what will form? CO will form. So let us see here in this reaction of the reduction only. So here you see zinc oxide, that is a metal oxide, iron oxides, dantian oxide, lead oxide, all these are what? All these four names are of the metal oxide. So whenever these metal oxide are reacted with carbon, then this metal oxide will convert into a metal, and also we will get the another important gas, that is CO, carbon monoxide will be produced here. Fe2O3 converts into carbon. When it reacts with carbon, it is producing what? It is producing carbon monoxide. So carbon turns into carbon monoxide, and along with this iron metal is produced here. So in all of these equation you see oxygen is written with the metal. After the metal atom only what is written? Oxygen is there. But when we are doing this reaction, what is happening? After the completing of this reaction, oxygen gas is removed from there. So that only you can observe, ZNO convert to Z. That is minus oxygen has taken place. Same way here also, minus O3. Rest are still there. So 3 oxygen kahan gaye honge? They are coming on the other side, that is 3CO. So that is where you can expect this carbon to convert into carbon monoxide. Last or 3 equations more are there, tin oxide, lead oxide, copper oxide. All these oxides will convert into the metal, lead oxide to lead, tin oxide to tin, and copper oxide to copper. And final thing is CO. CO is coming from carbon only. It combines with oxygen, produces carbon monoxide. So this reaction reduction is called carbon reduction, and it is very very important in metallurgy. Metallurgy is what? Metallurgy is the science of attracting metals from their ores and modifying them for the use. Metals and all whatever we are using, they are obtained from the earth crust and they are not pure. They have to be purified. So one of the step in the purification is this, that as you have read today, carbon reduction. By that only you get different objects made up of different kind of the metals. Next we will see the reduction of water. Here again removal of oxygen will take place. So whenever steam is passed over red hot coke, red hot means it is burning there, a mixture of the carbon monoxide and hydrogen will form. So carbon convert to carbon monoxide, hydrogen is also produced from the dihydrogen oxide, that is water. So water plus steam gives water gas. So this is how we have seen the reduction of water also. Reduction of the particular compound. Next, now water gas is of industrial importance, that is not required. So that is all up to today. We'll continue in the next upcoming video. Thank you for now.